वेलकम बैक अगेन टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल माई सेल्फ गौरव त्रिपाठी एज यू ऑल नो। सो टुडे वी केम हेयर विद ए सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ मॉडल्स। मीन्स इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वाट आर द मॉडल्स, वेयर दे आर यूज, इन विच सिचुएशन दे आर यूज एंड वाट दे सजेस्ट। एंड देयर ऑल्सो आफ्टर इंट्रोडक्शन आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड two models like can, could and that is may, might. So now here from we are going to start should. Okay, so listen it, watch it carefully and try to understand where was it used. Now I don't want to waste the time, so let's start our topic. So should, here you can say this is the model means should. Third model that is given here should, although if I say this is the fifth, may, might, can, could and then should. So should it used to express first duty and obligation. When there is any suggestion of duty or any obligation you are having, means we all are having different duties in our life, different obligations toward our family, toward our elder ones, toward our nation. So many things, so many duties we must keep. So for that purpose this model is used for duty and obligation. You can see here the example. First example that is given, you should stand by your brother, means he is saying you should stand by your brother, means in what situation, in what the problems your brother is facing, anyhow it is your responsibility, it is your duty to stand by. Stand by means support, to give support. So you should stand by, this is our duty. Okay, if our family members, they are going to in any problem or they are facing any situation that is not in their favor, so what is our responsibility, what is our duty? To support them, that is. Then second example, that is I should leave now. I should leave now, it means suppose that if you are working anywhere and you are just in the office and two senior persons, they want to make conversation on any secret thing, so now it is your duty, you should leave from there. Or we can say in another manner, suppose that if you have another work, you have another work and you want to go, or we can say you must go there. So in that case, you also say, I should leave now. It is my duty. I should leave. Ab mujhe jana chahiye. That is. So then the third, promises should be kept. Here promises should be kept means whatever the promises we are making or we had made with others, so it is our duty, it is our obligation to fulfill those promises. So that's why it is said promises should be kept. Then he should be present here. He should be present here. It is his duty, it is his obligation, means there is his need and he should be present here. In that case means usko yahan hona chahiye, usko yahan present hona chahiye. It is his duty, it is his time period, it is his work time. So in that case we can say this model is used. Now here one more thing I want to tell you, what that if there is a duty or obligation that is for more important, that is for more important, or you can say like a moral duty, there we use ought to. Okay, O-U-G-H-T, ought to, means this is also used in place of should, where it is moral duty, duty related to our nation, duty related to our motherland, दैट इज़ फॉर मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट मीन्स इफ़ यू मेक कंपेरिजन विद शुड इफ़ एनी ड्यूटी एनी ऑब्लिगेशन इज देयर दैट इज़ मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट इज़ मोर और कैन से ग्रेटर हैविंग ग्रेटर इम्पॉर्टेंस दैन इट देयर वी विल यूज़ ऑट टू रिमेंबर दिस ओके नाउ इट इज़ क्लियर सो नेक्स्ट फ्यूचर इन द पास्ट एज वी ऑल नो Future in the past means what is that it is also used as the past form of shall or will. It is used as the past form of shall or will. So in reported speech it is used as future in the past. Here you see I told him that I should go there. It is used here in reported speech means like when There is a direct sentence and you have converted this sentence into indirect speech or indirect sentence. So here shall is changed into should. In that case, it is used. Means future in the past. About past means whatever we had done and whatever we had announced in past in that case. Then Did I not tell you that I should qualify here again? It is like a clause. It you see here. Did I not tell you? This is in past clause. This is the sentence that is written in past tense. So it is also about past. So that's why should is used. In that case, it is future in the past. Then the third use that is purpose. The third use that is purpose you see purpose means for purpose it is used like walk carefully lest you should fall walk carefully lest you should fall he is telling you walk carefully means you are walking walk with care and what is the purpose behind walking carefully if you do not walk carefully you will fall the meaning is that okay means the purpose is behind Walking carefully, he wants to say, otherwise you will fall down. So the purpose is there, he is saying, he is giving advice. Walk carefully, lest you should fall. So here remember, if lest is coming, so only should will be used. Okay, walk carefully, lest you should fall. The Hindi meaning of this sentence, Savdhani purvak chalo kahin aisa na ho ki tum gir jao. That is means सावधानी पूर्वक चलो कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि तुम गिर जाओ So for purpose also it is used Then as a conditional sentence also it is used See here condition For condition in the place of if There are three types of conditional sentence How many types are three? Three types of conditional sentence that is generally start with If means there is one condition and the result is behind that condition or depend upon that condition. Means now read the sentence. Should you work hard, you will get success. You replace should with if. So if you work hard, you will get success. If you work hard, only then you will get success. Means condition is there. What is the condition? Working hard. The condition of working hard. If you work hard, you will get success. So here also in place of if, should is used. This is first type of conditional sentence. Actually, I am telling you three types of conditional sentence. In first, we are using, suppose there are two clauses. You can see here, should you work hard, one clause and you will get success. That is the another clause. So here the rule of these conditional sentence, I am telling you. What is the rule? If this clause means the clause that is having if it is in present tense, if it is in present tense, as you can say here, it is in present tense. So we will use in second clause will. Okay, means here you see will is used. If it is in past tense, simple past, then we will use would. Okay, if It is having have and third form, okay? Have and third form. Then in next class नेक्स्ट क्लॉज वी विल हैव वुड हैव, ओके वुड हैव, एंड थर्ड फॉर्म लाइक दैट. ओके नाउ इट इज क्लियर. मीन्स विद प्रेजेंट विल विल बी यूज इन द नेक्स्ट क्लॉज, विद पास्ट वुड विल बी यूज, एंड विद हैव प्लस थर्ड फॉर्म. इफ सपोज दैट इफ आई से इफ आई हैड गॉन देयर देन आई वुड हैव लाइक दैट वी विल यूज. सो दीज आर द कंडीशनल सेंटेंस हेयर. सो हेयर शुड इज यूज इन प्लेस ऑफ इफ, मीन्स शुड यू वर्क हार्ड यू विल गेट सक्सेस दैट इज. सो नाउ अगेन शुड हैव मीन्स वेयर एवर हैव इज यूज विद एनी मॉडल आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इट इज अबाउट पास्ट. It is about past. So this form is used to express obligation in the past. It may imply the non-performance of the action. Means it indicate about the past obligation that had not been performed. Means the activity that was expected but it was not done. That is. So here you should have stood by your brother. It is your duty. इट इज़ योर ड्यूटी यू शुड हैव स्टूड बाई योर ब्रदर. आपको अपने ब्रदर की सहायता के लिए खड़ा होना चाहिए बट एक्चुअली दैट वॉज योर ड्यूटी बट यू डिड नॉट डू दैट. दैट इज यू शुड हैव लेफ्ट ए मैसेज. आपको एक मैसेज छोड़ना चाहिए था लेकिन आपने ऐसा नहीं किया. इट इज़ योर ड्यूटी एट लीस्ट यू शुड हैव टोल्ड मी इन दैट केस. देन He should have been present at the party. He should have been present at the party. This is the passive form of should have. Means this is the passive. Here been is used, no? He should have been present at the party. My brother should have replied politely. Meri maa ko politely, in a polite manner, reply karna chahiye tha. But she did not. That is, means in the past form. Okay? Again, our next model, that is must. And must is used for mostly, I am telling you, wait, must is used for necessity and obligation that is given here. Means when anything that is required to do, that is necessary, where the need of that thing, compulsion or obligation also sometimes in the place of should. As I told you, should is used for obligation and duty. So must also sometimes used for obligation. And ought to is also used for obligation and duty. But I told you the difference between what is, that is in, between in should and ought to. So here necessity or obligation in place of should. So first sentence they have given, you must follow the follow instructions. It means you are required to read or you are required to follow whatever the instructions are being given to you. In that case, you must follow instruction that is necessary. That is the necessity. Must is always used for necessity. You must do that. It is necessity. Means you are required. You are required. So in that case, so you must follow instructions. Then again, I must leave now. In the case, you can say, I should leave now. In the both cases, this is the obligation. Means you can either use must or should. I must leave now or I should leave now. That is. Then, order of the speaker. Means when the speaker is giving any order, then also must is used. Or order means order in the case of imposing restrictions or to forbid anything. If you are going to do anything, if anyone is forbidding you to make that activity, in that case also we use must. Like you see, you must not leave now. Now I am giving you the order. This time you must not leave now. Means I am not giving you the order to, I am not giving you the permission to leave this place. You should stay here. You must stay here. You must not leave now. That is. Then they must not play here. It is also in the sense of order. means a few children they are going to play cricket. There is some place and at that playground they are going to play cricket, and this place belongs to any other person, and who is there, and who that person is imposing the restriction that you are not allowed to play here. They must not play here. That is, they must not play here. Order he is giving. That is, okay. Then a strong possibility. Okay, means for possibility may is also used, as I already told you. For possibility may is used and must is also, but must is used for a strong possibility. If you compare, means if there is a strong possibility, then only you use must. Like it is 10, the teacher must be in the class. Here the possibility is strong. Why it is strong? Because it is time, it is 10 o'clock and this is the time of class, so teacher must be in the class. Strong possibility, that is. Okay, if you are using here may, then it indicate not so strong possibility. So the teacher must be in the class. Then she must be working in the office now, means this time she will be there. So she must be working in the office now. So for strong possibility we use must in place of may. Remember this. Then for determination also, you can see, if you have decided anything, you determined anything that I will do that, so I must help him. I must help him. That is determination. You decided to help that person, so I must. You are saying I must help him. मुझे उसकी मदद करनी चाहिए. मुझे इसकी मदद करनी जरूरी है. Then deduction and inference. What is the meaning of deduction? Actually, deduction means use your logic. Means there is some clue you got, and on the basis of that clue you infer something. Infer means to get to know. Means on the basis of something you get to know other extra thing or other extra information, then it is called inference. Means reason is there. Using your logic, using your mind, you deduct something. That is. So here you see, he has a big house, he must be rich. So here reason is given, he has a big house. So on the basis of this reason, you deducted that. You inferred that he is a big house, that's why by just seeing his house, he is having a big house. That is like a mansion, palace. So it indicates he deducted, he used his mind that he must be rich. भाई इसके पास इतना बड़ा बंगला है, इतना बड़ा घर है, जिसका सीधा सा मतलब है कि वो अमीर होगा. He must be rich. He used his mind. उसको बताया नहीं गया कि वो अमीर है, लेकिन उसने ये सब देख के, जैसे किसी के पास बड़ी लग्जूरियस कार्स हैं, बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉपर्टी है, तो ये चीज़ें क्या इंडिकेट करती हैं कि वो रिच होगा, तभी तो ये सारी चीज़ें हैं. It means he is having all these things, he is having the properties, that is, and due to this he deducted that he must be rich. Then she reads a lot, she must be learned, means she reads a lot, so it indicates that she must be learned. Okay, means वो बहुत ज़्यादा पढ़ती है, इसका सीधा सीधा मतलब है वो पढ़ने में, या must be learned, अच्छी होगी, विद्वान होगी. That is. So again here came, you see, must have means have is used with modal. So as I already told you, if have is using with the modal, then it is about the past activity. You see, must have, the form is used for past action or situation indicating non performance, and the action did not take in past but that was required. Okay, means you must have followed instruction. आपको इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉलो करने चाहिए थे बट आपने नहीं किए. सो इन दैट केस आल्सो यू मस्ट हैव फॉलोड इंस्ट्रक्शंस, यू मस्ट हैव लेफ्ट देम, आपको उनको छोड़ देना चाहिए था. आई मस्ट हैव हेल्प्ड हिम, मुझे उसकी मदद करनी चाहिए थी, बट एक्चुअली इन रियलिटी आई डिड नॉट डू दैट. In that case, we can say must have is used. Okay. So again, our favorite model, that is ought to had come. Now you see, as I already told you, ought to is used for moral duty, moral obligation. When I taught you should, there I told you that we use ought to in place of should in this situation when there is moral obligation, moral duty. You see here, duty or moral obligation. It is normally used for should and must when there is strong sense of moral duty, advice or indication or correct action. Means when there is strong, when there is strong duty, strong moral obligation, strong advice, strong indication or correct action. In that case, we only use ought to. Like you see, you ought to serve your motherland. That is our moral duty. That is far most important. As a nation, means as a citizen, we should have respect, or we should have respect toward our nation. So what we say in place of should, we ought to. We ought to respect our nation. We ought to respect our national flag. We ought to be dedicated toward our country. Okay, in that case, we use this ought to. You ought to serve your motherland. आपको अपने मातृभूमि की सेवा करनी चाहिए. And you ought to serve your motherland. You ought to protect your motherland. This is our moral duty. And this is most important if you compare with other duties. Because this is the priority. This is the priority. Means for our nation is having great importance. That's why we are using this ought to. Then you ought to not, you ought not to take fatty food. That is also our advice. Advice is given. You ought to take food before leaving. That is also the correct action. Why? Because you are going to the office, so it is obviously you will return at the evening lately. So it is your I am giving you the advice, you take food before leaving. That is again ought to have is used. You see here, ought to have means with ought to have is used, so it indicate past. You can say the construction is used in relation of past action of duty that was not fulfilled, or an action that was neglected in the past. In that case, we will use ought to have. You can see, you ought to have taken care of your wife, but what? You haven't done that. Okay, that is, you neglected your duty. You neglected. You ought to have taken care of your wife. आपको अपनी वाइफ की देखभाल रखनी चाहिए थी, but आपने ऐसा नहीं किया. But आपने ऐसा नहीं किया. That was your moral duty. That was your obligation. लेकिन अफसोस की बात, आपने ऐसा नहीं किया. You ought not to have served your parents. Parents plays important role in our life. So it is our duty to take care of them. But here what he is saying, you ought not to have served your parent. आपने अपने parents की सेवा नहीं करी. अफसोस के साथ मुझे ये कहना पड़ रहा है, आपने अपने parents की सेवा नहीं करी. You ought to have servant your parent, करनी चाहिए थी आपको. Then he ought to have been present at the wedding of his friend, and this is advice or suggestion, like means he ought to have been present. उसको अपने friend की marriage में, wedding में होना चाहिए था, but he was not there. That is, he ought not to have smoked in the bus. Means बस में उसको स्मोकिंग नहीं करनी चाहिए थी, but unfortunately he had done that. So here, whenever any activity that is explaining about past situation, about past, and that should not be done, but unfortunately that was done, we use ought to have. Okay, now it's clear. Now that is to be. To be, I am telling you where it is used. Actually, to be. Here, be as in the starting, I had already told you, there are so many forms of be. Like is, are, am, was, were, be, being, been. They are the form of be. So, they if to be plus infinitive. And to, if just before verb, to is coming. Just before verb, to is coming. It means that is infinitive. Like is to, are to, am to, was to, were to. Okay? And just after to, there is verb. You can see in every sentence. Here what is written? I am to make. Verb is there, make. She is to leave. I was to make. I was to leave. Okay? In that case, this is used. So, here listen. Actually, in which cases these is to, are to, am to are used? Express plan. First thing, they express plan. If you have already made a plan and you want to make those plan execute. Okay? But this is not certain that you will do that or those plans will be enacted. Okay? There is not so much strong chance. In that case, we are using. You had made the plan and you are expressing. Like, I am to make a speech tomorrow. In that case, where is to, are to, am to are used, I am telling you, like, I am to make a speech tomorrow that मुझे कल स्पीच देना है. देना है means I made plan. देना है. Now I am telling you, there is difference between has to, have to and these is to, are to, am to. If we use I have to make a speech tomorrow, then there is a strong possibility. Means that is the necessity. कि मुझे ये करना पड़ेगा. If suppose that I am using here, I have to make a speech tomorrow. It means मुझे कल speech देना पड़ेगा. That shows or giving the emphasis on this plan. Certainly this plan will be executed. But here, it is made. Means the plan is made. You see, I am to make a speech tomorrow. Means मुझे कल speech देना है. Means I am going to give a plan. That is. In that case, same. She is to leave for the states after marriage. After marriage, just after marriage, she wants to leave for the states. She made the plan. Means she is to leave for the states. Usko shaadi ke just baad states ke liye leave karna hai. Leave karna hai means jana hai. In that case. Then past form means like was. Was is always used in the past. So I was to make a speech yesterday. Mujhe kal speech dena tha. I was to make a speech yesterday. That was planned. But I didn't do that. I was to make a speech yesterday. She was to leave for the states for higher studies. Usko higher study ke liye jana tha. Means she was about to leave. She was about to leave for the states for higher study. In that case, to be plus infinitive is used. Okay? The last two sentences do not state expressly about implementation of the plan. As I told you, that the last two sentences do not state expressly about implementation. The plan was made, but it was not implemented. That is. So, now you see. It is also used in the sense of must. You can see express order. The students are to wait outside. That is the order given in place of must. This also can be used. Like students are to wait outside. Students ko bahar hi wait karna hai. Means this must wait there outside. The servants is to remain in the house till we return. This is also just indicating the sense of must. The servant is to remain in the house till we return. जब तक मैं वापस नहीं आ जाता तब तक सर्वेंट को घर में ही रहना है. ओके दैट इज देन ऑल्सो इट इज़ यूज फॉर ऑब्लिगेशन एंड ड्यूटी. आई एम टू हेल्प माई एलिंग ब्रदर. एलिंग मीन्स कष्ट में होना. मीन्स माई ब्रदर वॉज सफरिंग, माई ब्रदर वॉज एक्सपीरियंसिंग पेन. सो दैट्स वाई आई एम टू हेल्प माई एलिंग ब्रदर. मुझे मेरे भाई की हेल्प करनी है. दैट इज़ द ऑब्लिगेशन, दैट इज़ द ड्यूटी. इन दैट केस ऑल्सो इज टू आर टू एम टू इज़ यूज. रिमेंबर माई फ्रेंड वॉज टू सेंड मनी टू हिज सिस्टर. दिस वॉज ड्यूटी ऑफ माई फ्रेंड और बिकॉज आई एंड माई सिस्टर बोथ वर सफरिंग फ्रॉम अ प्रॉब्लम. दैट्स वाई माई फ्रेंड वॉज टू सेंड मनी टू हिज सपोज नो 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 लिसन माई फ्रेंड वॉज टू सेंड मनी टू हिज सिस्टर. मीन्स हिज सिस्टर मीन्स इट इज हिज ड्यूटी, इट इज़ हिज ड्यूटी. ही मीन्स वॉज टू सेंड मनी बट रियलिटी ही डिड नॉट डू दैट. दैट इज फॉर दैट ऑल्सो वी यूज ऑब्लीगेशन. फॉर ऑब्लीगेशन एंड ड्यूटी वी यूज. नाउ केम हेयर टू बी प्लस हैव मीन्स लाइक हैज टू हैव टू. इन दैट केस नो नो टू बी प्लस हैव दैट इज दिस एक्सप्रेशन इज मेड टू एक्सप्रेस एन एक्शन दैट कुड नॉट टेक प्लेस अकॉर्डिंग टू प्लान. मीन्स ही वॉज टू हैव अटेंडेड मैरिज बट फेल इल. इन दैट केस मीन्स इट इज ऑल्सो यूज मीन्स वॉज इज यूज ना. दैट्स वाई ही वॉज टू हैव अटेंडेड मैरिज बट फेल इल. द एक्सप्रेशन इज यूज टू एक्सप्रेस एन एक्शन दैट कुड नॉट टेक प्लेस अकॉर्डिंग टू प्लान. अकॉर्डिंगली इट वॉज नॉट इम्प्लीमेंटेड, इट डिड नॉट टेक प्लेस. इन दैट केस ही वॉज टू हैव अटेंडेड मैरिज बट फेल इल, बट ही फेल इल. ओके दैट्स वाई ही वॉज टू हैव अटेंडेड मैरिज बट फेल इल. दीपू वॉज टू हैव अपियर्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन बट सी गेव अप द प्लान. मीन्स दीपू वॉज ऑल्सो सी मेड अ प्लान टू अपियर इन द एग्जाम बट सी गेव अप द प्लान. दैट इज इन दैट केस वी यूज दिस. So now our most important use of to have, you see, where means have to, has to, had to is used, as I told you, for must means that action is necessary. As I told you na, padega, padega and karna hai. Aapko karna padega aur karna hai, dono mein difference hai. There is a big difference between these two. Karna padega is showing strong possibility or duty or that is required to do. So here you see to have. Like this expression is used to express compulsion. Compulsion as is expressed with must. Okay, like must means in must also we show the compulsion. So here it also express obligation like in the present, past and future. You see, I have to leave for Delhi today. Mujhe aaj hi Delhi ke liye jana padega. I have to leave. Mujhe aaj hi Delhi jana padega. So it is compulsion. I cannot skip this. I have to leave for Delhi today. That is. Then I don't have to meet him now. Means in the case of need not, it is used here. This is also compulsion or express obligation like. I don't have to meet him now. अब मुझे उससे मिलने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. अब मुझे उससे नहीं मिलना पड़ेगा. That is. I don't have to meet him now. Or you can say, I have not to meet him now. Both the sentences carry the same. Okay. Then I will have to get up early in the morning. Mujhe subah jaldi uthna padega. I will have to get up early in the morning. I had to leave for Delhi yesterday. This is about past. Means I had to leave for Delhi yesterday. Yesterday I had to leave earlier. I had to leave for Delhi yesterday earlier. It was executed. Okay, that was also compulsion related to past. I did not have to meet him there. Here again, it is used as need not have. Okay, in that case, if you are using have to, has to and had to, it indicates strong possibility or compulsion. That is the action you must do. That is. So now we are coming used to and would. They are used like you see. First, to denote habitual action or the past routine of the subject. Habitual action. If there is anything related to used to, so this already I told you when I described tenses, and I will also make a video on tenses, and that is I will explain where used to is used. Okay, actually used to is used in like past habit or habitual action regarding past, but now it is stopped. Like he used to go Delhi by car. पहले क्या होता था, वो दिल्ली कार से जाया करता था. That was his habit. He used to go to Delhi by car, but now he is not going by car. That is means the habit is left now. So he used to go to Delhi by car. Now he used not to go to Delhi means वो दिल्ली नहीं जाता था, but अब उसने start कर दिया. He used not to go to Delhi in that case. He did not use to go to Delhi. This is about past. He did not use, in that case also we can say he did not use to go. These three sentences, they only used in past activities. Dina would study at noon. Dina would study at noon. Would and used to both are used for habitual action or past routine. Remember, Dina would study at noon. She would go out with me in the evening. That is also related to past activity. As I told you, would is also the form of will in the past. If you are changing direct into indirect sentence, then it plays the role of past. Okay, so remember this. Then to denote discontinued action. Now the action was discontinued. That is the same thing that I described earlier. He used to play cricket, but now he is not playing. He used to play hockey. Now he has stopped. Okay. She used to work in office before marriage. Before marriage, she used to work in office, but now she is not working. In that case. Okay. Then we are coming. He used to is also used as an adjective. Be used to. It is equal to accustomed to. Used to is also used as an adjective. Like be used to, and this is here the meaning of used to is accustomed to. Accustomed to the same meaning habit. Like he is used to getting up early. He was used to driving through crowded street. He will be used to taking dinner early. We are used to hot noons in the plains. In that case, we are using. Means when we are accustomed to. Means ऐसा करता था. He is used to getting up early. Okay, in that case he is used to getting up early. I was means accustomed to का अभ्यस्त होना, आदत पड़ जाना. Accustomed to का मतलब क्या, आदत पड़ जाना. That is. Then the use of would, that is the last model of this session. And then need not and dare not and bare infinitive I will discuss in next session. Okay. So where after would, I will just bind up this session. Here you see would is used. First, would you please help my son? Polite request. As I told you that when I taught you could, use of could. Could is also used for polite and would. And when you compare with these two, so could is more polite. Remember this, could is more polite. So would you please help my son? That is the request. She told me that she would give me money. Here would is used for the past action. Future in the past mean in place of will. When you change direct into indirect, then it indicates would. No? We will replace that will into would. That is, she told me that she would give me money. In that case, we are using would. Then I would or I should like to play now. This is wish. For wish also would is used. I would like to play now. Means this is showing wish. I would like to be a teacher. I would like to be a doctor. In that case, we are using, that shows wish. I would be glad to help you. Okay, there's also wish. I would rather stay. This is also his wish. Who is she? She would be his sister. Possibility. For possibility also it is. So, who is she? She would be his sister. And for possibility may is also used, na? He may be his wife, okay, in that case. Or must is also used. She must be her wife. She must be his wife in that case. I just changed pronoun. In previous sentence also, whatever I spoke, just I changed. Means in place of he, I spoke she. So this is my mistake. You correct it. So who is she? She would be his sister, possibly. Who is she? She would be his sister. That shows possibility. She would be 16, you see, okay? And then again wish, if only you would stay with me, this is my wish, if only you would stay with me. He would go to Delhi by car, that is habitual. Means for these things, would is used. Means for, you see, polite request, future in the past, wish, possibility, wish, habitual action. Means for these things, would is used. So remember this, okay? Now I hope it is clear. Whatever the models I just covered. So, and later I will describe need and need not and dare not. Okay, later I will describe these things. So now I am going to bind up this session, and for introduction of the models, you see my previous video, my last video I made on the topic of models. There I gave introduction about models, where they are used. So now we are binding this session. Okay.